Coverage of the National Football League is on the air. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the New York Jets and the London Bulldogs. A pair of 3-0 teams set to lock horns for the right to remain unbeaten, and we're off in week four. Taken about 7 yards deep, and they will elect to not bring this one out as our first drive will begin at the 25. First carry of the game, and he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. 10 yards there to start the drive, and just enough by about the length of the football for a first down.
It's a gain of 10. First down, New York.
Now Sanders, and he'll get this up to about the 38-yard line. A gain of 3, second down.
Look, all any running back wants is a little bit of room, a little bit of space in order to maneuver. But he also understands how difficult it is for his offensive line up front. So if they give him any space, he realizes his job to make more out of it than what they give him. Picks up 3 on that carry.
Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
First down, New York.
Now they'll throw here out of the gun. That's complete to Moss out of the backfield.
Complete to.
Good job there to locate his tight end, Charles, in the middle of the field.
Yeah, he has good pass-catching abilities, and if they're able to continue to find him here in the early going, I think it'll help out his teammates out on the perimeter. You can take the big shots later if he occupies their attention.
6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
Yeah, once more, strong running, excellent blocking at the point of attack. They've got a nice little drive brewing right here.
On play action, they'll throw. He'll buy some time right, and this is incomplete.
So much for the best laid plans and best designed plays. That was good coverage along the sidelines. No place for that one to get in there. It sails incomplete.
So line of scrimmage, still the 39 on 2nd and 10. He'll fire deep downfield for Lamb. And this throw will be intercepted. Jonathan Abram picks it. They may have thrown the interception, obviously less than ideal, but I think they also sent a message that they're going to push the ball downfield in this one.
Yeah, not afraid to take their shots right away, huh? What was that, like a 9-9-9 route? 9 meaning go? Just went ahead and went for it. Didn't work out so well because it certainly appeared the defense was prepared. But I'm with you. Okay, so it didn't work this time. Doesn't mean we won't try it again later.
So they'll come up 1st and 10 now from the 33. First carry for Josh Jacobs. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
Brings up 2nd and 5.
The first down run got 5. Here's 2nd and 5. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. Got a man open. It's Ross. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. That one good for 26 and a first down.
At the 36-yard line.
Now a toss to the left for Jacobs. this all the way down to the 9. A big chunk on the ground there, 27 yards. That was excellent from start to finish, from the blocking to the running, just well executed.
And now let's look ahead, because after that, how about a little play action, maybe a little bootleg, and get the quarterback out on the corner and give him a little run-pass option.
And they're right down here looking for 6. First and goal, a chance to convert that early turnover into points. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. It'll be a 3-yard pickup, and it brings up second and goal. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
And they're going to go jet sweep here. This is Ross with it. And he will take this one in for a touchdown. John Ross, his 5th touchdown now on the year. And his guys have taken a first quarter lead. So really a nice drive there for the first points of the game.
And how about the fact that it was a run by the wide receiver that got him into the end zone, Brandon? You know, these guys, we know they're not afraid to open up the playbook, and they showed it to us right there on the first drive.
Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. Fielded in the end zone. And he's probably realizing he should have stayed in the end zone, as he can only muster a return to the 14-yard line.
Well, conventional football, football 101, tells us if you don't get it back to the 20-yard line on a kickoff return, that's a disappointment. But some of these teams, special teams coaches, with approval by the head coach, they give them full authority to go ahead and bring it out and try to be aggressive. Almost what we call the green light, red light theory. Green light means go, red light means stop. Looks like he had green on that play.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's 2nd and 7.
Brings up 2nd and 7 at the 17.
Now this one complete downfield on the left side. And way up past the 35 before he's taken down. A gain there of 21 yards. So here's a 1st and 10 at the 38. They'll run with Sanders. And that'll be good for 8 yards to the 45.
Miles Sanders.
Well, they're making an effort to get the ground game going tonight. So far, it's working.
I like what we're seeing from the offensive line. They seem to have the leverage going, and they're controlling things and reestablishing the line of scrimmage, moving that defensive front backwards. But also like what the runner's giving us, too. It appears that he's been waiting all day long to get out here and take off.
A gain of 11.
Last drive, remember, similar situation. He forced a ball into coverage through the pick. He learned better there.
Yeah, similar to a golfer that's confronted with a shot that you just can't make. Sometimes you have to take your medicine, as they say, right? Just pull it down, take off, and go. Don't make something worse than what it was.
The intended receiver was Thaddeus Moss. That'll bring up 2nd down. Here's a quick throw out left. That's caught. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And all the way in. Touchdown, New York. CeeDee Lamb. His 2nd touchdown on the season. And the Jets are an extra point away from tying this thing up. Now Adam Gase has put a pair of fingers up in the air. His offense is going to go for 2. They'll try and throw for it. And no, it falls incomplete. So the 2-point conversion, no good.
So what do you think the mindset was there? You can tie it with a PAT here first half. Why go for the lead right now?
The old school mindset says if you have a better team, you just go ahead and continue to try and dominate. There's also a school of thought, if you don't think you're quite as good, you have to try and take advantage of opportunities. And finally, I just think this is analytics coming into the game. Someone saying the more you go for 2, the better your chances are of actually getting them.
They'll start out here with a jet sweep. A.J. Terrell coming up to make the play.
A.J. Terrell on the tackle. 4 yards on the pickup.
After 1, a 1-point game, 7-6.
Lions. We own it. We own it. 44 to Mike. Check.
On second down, Jacobs. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. It's a first down on a gain of 10. His first carry of their second drive, pretty solid. And, of course, remember back to their first drive, really strong throughout that one.
Not only is he getting good blocking up front, but how about his vision to find the holes? And he's seeing things before they even open and hurtling through them.
On first down, they look downfield, and it's complete. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. That'll be marked as a 27-yard pickup.
London, first down. First and 10 at the 19-yard line.
Running the toss here to Jacobs. And they go the wrong way here. Knocked back to the 20. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
After getting stuffed on first down, not much better there. 2-yard gain.
Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
He's going to have the hook up to Ross. Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short.
Brings up fourth down and one.
They go with Jacobs. And he's got the first down as he gets it to the 8. They only got a couple, but they need it as they convert on fourth. Here's Jacobs. And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. It's a gain of a couple, and it'll be second and goal. Defensively, pretty good start there with their backs against the wall.
That's a win for the stop troops right there. And if I'm them, I get a little bolder now. They won the first battle. Keep coming after them. Put the pressure on them.
And a minuscule gain of maybe a yard from the 6 to the 5.
Tackle made at the 5.
Defensively, they had that one pretty well figured out.
Yeah, one of the things about this play, it can be even more effective when you run a lot of motion and there's plenty of times you don't hand it off.
What a stand this would be if they can get the stop here. Third and goal. Here's Jones, and he'll get it down close to the goal line, but not quite in. It's a pickup of 3, and we have now arrived at the 2-minute warning. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. Coming up at the half, a reminder, we go back to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman. He'll have a look back at our first half, as well as a look ahead to what's coming up later this weekend. They'll run it with Jacobs, and he is into the end zone for a touchdown. Josh Jacobs, his third touchdown now on the year. And his guys find a way to stretch that lead. So they went for it from the 1 on 4th and goal, and they got it done.
Is this the new NFL?
This is the new NFL.
This is the updated NFL, and I like it. I know.
know that quarterbacks across the league have spent the entire offseason and even during the season lobbying their coaches to go for it more on fourth down. Let's go get it. Because nowadays, you've got to score points to win games in the NFL. You can't just rely on your defense to hold them.
I think the quarterbacks want to eliminate field goals inside of 30 yards, probably.
Well, listen, they have enough confidence in themselves that they can call plays and make plays that they won't need those field goals inside the 30.
Take over first and 10 at their own 21-yard line.
Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. They'll try and start this drive in the air. Pressure from his right, and he goes down hard, flat on his back. The number one pick, Myles Garrett, coming in to drop him.
It's second down.
Second and long. He's going to let this one go deep. But when this ball's tipped and intercepted. Picked off by Trayvon Mullen. And the possession is theirs at their own 43-yard line. Second interception for him now here in this first half. And you got to think he's a rookie, Charles. How much does confidence start to become a factor?
I think that's a great question because that's what they're going to check on when he gets to the sidelines. The coach is going to check on it. His teammates are going to check on it. Because when you haven't done it before, it's not something that's part of you. You got to see how you're going to react. Let's see how he bounces back.
Yeah, because two interceptions for him in college and a half. I mean, that just didn't happen. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. Jacobs now. And he takes it past the 45 and down at the 46. He was 4 yards on the pickup there as they get it back to a more manageable third and 7.
Makes it third and 7.
They'll drop to throw. Got a man, it's Ross, complete. And he's going to have a first down, and they get into field goal range here at the 29.
First and 10 at the 29-yard line.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. He's going to let it go deep for the end zone. And it's caught. Touchdown. Chase Claypool. As the first half is winding down. And his guys are going to add on to their lead. I'll let you do the analysis, partner, but with every touchdown pass this young quarterback throws and with the success that his team has had, I just continue to be more and more impressed.
Let's both do the analysis. Impressed. Aren't we both?
Yeah.
I mean, why shouldn't we be? We've seen him improve throughout the year. We've seen him settle in now, and you can see the confidence of the team has grown. His confidence has grown. I think that everyone around this guy feels good about what they've seen, and it's also safe for him when he's driving home to turn on Sports Talk Radio. He's okay.
That'll be taken about a yard deep. And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15.
At their own 15-yard line.
Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. And you got to think, if this is anything other than just taking a knee, I'd be very surprised.
Yeah, they've got enough to talk about at the half. Why do anything else? Just get out of there.
And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. And with just 1 second remaining in the first half, they'll call the timeout. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. And he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far. As it's time now to send you back stateside to Orlando, Florida, and check in with Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. Coach! As they say here in London, all to play for as we are back underway in the second half. This taken in about 4 yards deep. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
First and 10 at their own 24-yard line.
The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. They are just putting things together so well here, drive after drive. They really have captured the momentum, haven't they?
They've taken momentum and pretty much not just give him a jersey, but a seat on the bench as well. Whatever do you need, you've got it, because the way they're stringing things together and creating that distance between them and their opponent, it's really hard to narrow that gap. And the other part is they're taking their spirit away from them, too.
And now they're just looking to add to that total. They go play action here on first down. Going deep downfield. Got a man that's caught inside the 10. And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. 33 yards that time.
At the 8-yard line.
Now a carry for Jacobs. And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. Only a yard that time, second and goal. The line of scrimmage, the 7 now on second and goal. Now keep in mind, if you're thinking of staying on the ground, this is a top 5 rush defense.
Yeah, but I don't think you shy away totally with the run. At least show them the hint of a run before you decide to throw the football.
One more time with Jacobs. And that'll move him a little closer as he takes it from the 7 down to the 4-yard line.
His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease, anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back. It just never materialized.
Third and goal at the 4-yard line. And he'll take it into the end zone for a touchdown. Josh Jacobs with his second touchdown of the game, fourth of the year. And his guys find a way to stretch that lead.
Well, they decided to run it in and got it done on third and goal. A lot of times, that's a passing play.
And the kicker, this has to come out for the PAT. He can breathe a sigh of relief as well, right?
Although, I don't know if he's really breathing a sigh of relief. I think he likes to put 3 points on his ledger.
Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. Taken in the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one.
First and 10. At their own 18-yard line.
Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter 3, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. He's going to drop this down to Sanders. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. And it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
Number 26.
Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8. When we talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done, because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down.
Gain on the play. First down, New York.
On first and 10, it's Sanders. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
Taken down at the 41. A gain of 2. Brings up second and 8.
A quick throw complete into the flat out left. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down.
Third down.
They're going to look to throw. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And he picks up the first before he's taken down at the 29. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive.
New York.
They'll run on first down.
Sanders.
And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8. Second and 2. 8 yards the tally on that first down run. Here's second and 2.
On the pickup, brings up second and 2.
And he's got his man in stride, complete. And they'll get this down to the 10.
To number 13.
That's what we're used to seeing from him right there. Plays like that, why he's number 4 in the league in terms of receiving yardage.
Able to make adjustments all along the way. Doesn't matter where he lines up, where he releases from. Working his way into the secondary, figures out defenses and finds weak spots in order to get open.
One quarter remains here in this Thursday night matchup. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Circle round twice for the encore. If you know, you know. So not quite a first and goal. It's first and 10 from the 10. He'll look to throw. Forced out to his left. He'll try and run it. It won't be a sack, but it's no gain, and it brings up second down.
Well, the defensive guys won't be real happy because there won't be a sack on this play because he did get back to the line of scrimmage. But what a job they did overall. Hemmed him in and gave him nowhere to go with the football.
And that play going absolutely nowhere as he's belted before he could get out of the backfield. He lost 4 there, and it's third down.
I think this offense, specifically this running game, they're going to have to find a way to turn the page because they haven't found a way to run it effectively thus far, and it's cost them.
Third down now. Those last two plays indicative of how things have gone for them. Just nowhere to go on the ground and struggling to put up points. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain there, and it leads to a fourth down.
No gain on the play. It's now fourth down.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. Flushed out right. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Jonathan Abram picks it. A young quarterback, Charles, rolling to his right. I know he's right-handed, but is that one that maybe a veteran sticks in his pocket?
I think so, but you have to remember with young quarterbacks, it may take a few years before they get all the stuff out of them that they did earlier in their career or even in their college days when they were used to being dominant. In this case, the NFL veteran defense ended up winning the battle.
They'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
Brandon, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there. Now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
Finding room at the 30, and finally taken down at the 36-yard line. 16 yards, a first down.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with, and throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he's the guy they've turned to, and it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got the confidence to keep handing it to him and keep picking up good yardage.
And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
And 11 at the 35 yard line.
And a flag comes in as that one falls incomplete. Let's see who this is on. Clearly wasn't outside of the tackle box. There's your penalty.
And accompanying that penalty, a loss of down.
So now it's third and long, because remember, they also lose a down on the grounding call. 18, 18, 18. Right there, right there. 56. It's been a long day. They'll set up a throw. Able to hit his target, Claypool. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. A heck of a play there on third down, but amazingly, they're still short for fourth.
I don't know how many times, not just in my playing career, but you and I working together, have we ever heard a coach say, you know, I just don't have that play on my call sheet. And that's really what we had here. That was a big hole they were trying to get out of.
Yeah, big gain, still a ways to go, though. He's going to rifle one deep left side. That's caught inside the 20. And he takes it down deep into enemy territory. Wow, first and goal, and defensively all they can do is shake their heads. Not only did they allow the conversion, but a big play as well. So it's our home team here in possession of the football as we come back. They've got it first and goal in a game that appears to have already been decided. And he will take this one in for a touchdown. Taking it in from 4 yards out. And his guys are going to add on to their lead. Starting to really smell a 4-0 start right now. Yeah, can't ask for a better first quarter of the season than that.
And you're not supposed to look ahead, but guess what? They have to, because when you get to 4, if you get to 4-0, you're not just thinking playoffs now. You're thinking about, okay, this team has the capabilities of winning a Super Bowl. They could very well be the best team in the NFL at this point.
I think they played the best. I mean, there have been a few hiccups offensively and defensively, but probably the best team we've seen, right?
And has the ability to get better.
Chris Boswell set to kick off.
So with a missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line.
At their own 17-yard line.
Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. Remember, they have won three straight, but getting to four straight does not appear to be in the cards as they are in a big fourth quarter hole. They're going to be stopped up on this first down run. He might have gotten back to the line of scrimmage, but that's it. So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10.
On the play, second and 10 at the 17-yard line.
Dancing to his left. Now he'll pull it down.
Sometimes guys get locked into such a groove. What do we call it? The game slowing down. They see everything happening almost in slow motion. They see the lanes develop. I feel like he's right there.
Well, and you want this from your leader, right? With this deficit, this stage of the game, second half, no quit in him.
Zero.
There to stop him on the defensive side, Lorenzo Carter.
Brings up second and 7.
Buying time to his left. And that'll be incomplete. Another pass attempt, another incompletion, and they're just a little over 100 yards passing here in this game. So defensively, pretty good job.
Definitely, because they were never really able to get the ball in the hands of their playmakers. So a lot of credit to the defensive game plan and especially the execution.
Able to hit his target, Lamb. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40.
Well, it wasn't a big strike, but that completion put them in really great range. What do we have now, fourth and inches?
Yeah, it's not more than a half a foot.
You know what I would do here?
You would always go for it.
I'm one of those guys.
The offense here not budging. They're going to fight for it on fourth and inches. Going for it with Sanders. And he's got the first down as he's up to the 45-yard line. But no reason not to try it there, and they do indeed convert on fourth.
Thought they might throw the football with a little chunk that they had remaining on fourth down, but they ran it, they got it.
And the reason they were able to get it done, he ran that play with conviction, didn't he? Understood he would get a little bit of help from his friends up front, and it was really on him to go ahead and make the power move and get it done, and that he did.
The Jets are going to use the first of their timeouts. As the clock will stop with an even 20 seconds left to go. On first down, he'll drop to throw. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off by Justin Reed. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Down pass. Intercepted. They'll take over first down.
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And this game comfortably in hand. The scoreboard speaks for itself, but you still got your starting quarterback out there. When do you go to the back? The football comes out. Jacobs lost it. And one of the whistles for a timeout. So they'll stop the clock here in a game that's been decided in the closing seconds. Second and short now following the fumble. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. Going deep downfield for Ross. That's caught at the 25. And he takes it in for the score on the game's final play. So it doesn't affect the outcome. But a little whipped cream on top to their ending.
Or as our friends in Bayou Country would say, that's a little lagniappe, a little extra on top.
Well, Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So for London, hey, they finish a perfect month of September as they move to 4-0 on the new campaign. And now it's off to Heathrow as they get set to fly back to the U.S. in a couple hours. Meanwhile, for the Jets, the defeat is their first of the year as they drop to 3-1. And they'll get a chance to redeem themselves at home next week. Thanks for tuning in, everybody. Alongside Charles Davis, we thank our entire crew. I'm Brandon Gordon. This is the NFL on EA Sports.
The good news is you made a lot. I said, what's the bad news? The bad news is you spent more. Okay. Look. Sometimes you need the faith. Sometimes you need to know your worth. Sometimes you need to wait. Shoot like the golden boy, but ain't from the bay. You can't negotiate with Drake. You gon' have to pay. But wait. Jugging on the main stage. The mainframe. Loosen up your face, baby. Sometimes I need a protect my energy before engagement.
Grew up having nothing, you're labeled impatient. But once the boss made it, you're labeled amazing. Meticulous with words, such a force of nature. Boss. I don't want to seem absurd, but that boy's a gangster. Focusing on me, way from Tel Aviv. Barbados with the hustle pockets, LIDs. Distinctive destinations, all I want to see. Oceanfront residences, three different ones a week. Cause I deserve that. It's time to learn that. Mess around and put that thing up where your permit. Six figures every year, yeah, I earn that.
At the front of this line is where my turn at.
Sometimes you need a friend, not the ones that just show up and don't put nothing in. You know the ones that lend a hand and want to see you win. When you come up on that lick, make sure you cut them in. And then, sometimes you need a foe. Oh, men gon' lie, women gon' lie. You're looking for the truth and the numbers don't hide. Looking for the root of all evil, then you need to go open up the briefcase, see what your eyes. Everybody claim to be great at spa times, but they never spend a day in the rain in the front line. No lie. Stop playing on my phone line. Pull up in the space coupe with the roof optional. Wonder why they follow suit.